Right, the next question, are we diagnosing diabetes on time? If you think that we are diagnosing diabetes on time, you may type number 3, yes. Or if you think no, we are not diagnosing diabetes on time, then you may type no.
Yes, just put a 4 or put a no, okay? Yep. So let's share. This is going to be the first secret, by the way. This is going to be the first secret. Are we diagnosing diabetes on time? Okay, let's move on.
Okay. Right, so this in one, order to we'll understand...
We'll do a quick one because I believe many question, are diabetic.
Okay, I will do a very quick one. Okay, diabetes, knowing the symptom. Of course, these 10 symptoms are not the all the symptoms. Okay, this is just the
they are not exclusive.
The more common one, the more common one. Of course, there are more, way more than these symptoms. All right. So patients who are diabetic, they tend to feel more tired. Okay, the reason is because the blood sugar always stay in the blood vessel. And unable to go into the cells. That's why they will be always feeling very tired, always want to sleep, always feeling hungry, always thirsty, want to drink water. Moving on, frequent urination. Yeah. And they even have this problem of having night urination whereby they wake up more than 2 times in the night just to urinate, and this will in turn affect their sleep. And the whole day will be gone because the productivity will reduce because of lack of sleep. Moving on, sudden weight loss is also one of the symptoms of diabetes. Okay? Sudden weight loss is not only one of the symptoms for cancer, okay? But a person who just diagnosed with diabetes will get a very sudden weight loss, like maybe 10 kilos in about 2 months. You know, then they will realize, oh, I'm a diabetic. Wounds that won't heal, this is quite common in the clinical setting, whereby the patient will come with a wound that hasn't healed yet for about a month already, although it's just a very small cat scratch. Okay, it might just be a very small cat scratch or a mosquito bite scratch, but it didn't heal for about a month. So it is during that time that they will find out that the doctor will, they will go to the doctor, and then the doctor will ask, do you have diabetes? He say, no, I never have diabetes. Okay, but in fact, after checking the blood sugar will be sky high, will be very high. So this is the problem of diabetic patients, because the reason is because of high, very good sugar inside the bloodstream, whereby the bacteria will tend to stick to the wound, so it will delay the healing. That is one reason. Number 2 is the poor blood circulation of diabetic patient, where sometimes they will even get into this numbness, whereby because of this numbness, they won't realize that they have a wound under their feet. So they will, because of that, they won't take care of that wound and delay the healing. Moving on, sexual problems to guys whereby the third leg unable to stand up, erectile dysfunction, in other words. This one, men will be very embarrassed to tell the doctors. Usually will be the lady, the other half, the wife, will be complaining to the doctor, oh no, my husband has this erectile dysfunction and we are unable to enjoy our sex life. So this is the problem of guys. But God is very fair. So if male has problem, female will also have problem, which is this vagina infection. And other problems like urinary tract infection are also very common in diabetic patients. The higher the sugar level, they will tend to get more of this urinary tract infection. In fact, every year they might get these symptoms of fever. And they don't even have to get this the burning sensation when they are urinating. Okay, so this is one of the common symptoms. Blurry vision, okay, whereby we know that diabetic patients, the higher the sugar, it will affect your blood vessels in the eyes. Okay? And then that's why we always advise our diabetic patients to go for the eye checkup regularly. Okay? Among our beloved audience, do you know which are the symptoms, which is the symptom that is the commonest symptoms of diabetes? The commonest symptoms of diabetes. If you think it is tired, then you may write tired. If you think it is sudden weight loss, then you may write sudden weight loss. If you think it is sexual problems, then you may write erectile dysfunction or wound that won't heal. Now, which one is the commonest symptoms of diabetes? Or you think it's always hungry, or it may be your own personal experience that you are facing this problem. So which one do you think is the commonest symptoms of diabetes? Mm. So waiting for the answers, I may
back to the question just now. Actually, most people say that we are not diagnosing diabetes on time. Oh, we seem to have a very clever crop, right? That's very good. Yeah. So there are a lot of answers coming in now. Always tired. Okay. Urination, wound not healing, tired. Oh, tired. We have two answers now. Always hungry. By Neuralin. Yep. Okay. Thank you so much for sharing. Tired. Jenny said tired. Okay. Thirsty, hungry, wound that won't heal. Ooh, there seems to be an accurate answer that pop up. I think let us review the answer now, okay? Because time is running out. Let's go on.
So the commonest symptoms of diabetes is no symptoms. Okay? That's exactly why a lot of people don't know, right? So there are two phases of type 2 diabetes, okay, whereby you can see here, this is the blood glucose level, whereby lower than 6 will be considered as normal over here, right? So, and then years to diagnosis or end of follow-up. Over here, this patient has diagnosed with diabetes at this phase, whereby for the past 12 years over here, from negative 12 to negative 2, about 10 years, this patient has been slowly having increasing blood glucose level. And yet,
in a very gradual manner.
Yes, in a very gradual manner. And yet, the doctor will tell, oh, your glucose level is normal. Normal, no problem, no problem. But yet, suddenly he was being diagnosed with diabetes. And this one, of course, is the one without diabetes. And let's look at this study done by this craft. This graph pattern is not a very small study. It is done in more than 14,000 people. And how he did this study was by taking the insulin level of these people. Right, we can see during fasting, the insulin level is, of course, low. Okay? But about half an hour later, 1 hour later, 2 hours later, it will slowly increase. And the person with lower insulin level, which is this blue line, of course, is they are not having diabetes. And how about this red color and also the yellow and orange lines? They are actually diabetic. But yet, this yellow and orange line, they were told that, no, you are not having diabetes because their blood glucose level was normal. Okay? So this craft has tested 14,000 of people, and 75% of the people has normal glucose result, which is they failed the craft test. Why they failed? Because they were diabetic. Moving on. So now we are revealing secret number one. We are diagnosing diabetes 10 years too late.